Well, good morning. It is Tuesday. Wait a minute, just a second. Let me read this off of my notes here. It's Tuesday, July the 14th.
That's correct.
All right, I got it. Praise God. Well, we want to talk about, and this sounds like a different kind of a topic, you know, but it's the executive of the Godhead. And what we mean by that is of God, the Father God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. We believe they're three in one, but each one has a purpose.
Amen.
And so who is it that is here today with us, Marcia?
That's right. The Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit, right. Exactly.
I like saying the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost. That's good. Well, John 16:7 says this, "But in fact, it is best for you that I go away, because if I don't, the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, won't come. If I go away, then I will send him to you." And so for every believer that receives Jesus Christ.
That was a promise, wasn't it? Before
yes.
he left this earth.
Amen. Well, that was the promise of the Father. You know, Jesus said the Father has a promise for you, and that is that the Holy Spirit will come not only upon you as he did in the Old Testament,
yes.
but literally to live within you.
Praise God.
Acts says, "Know you not that you're the temple of the Holy Ghost?"
Amen.
So, you know, when we like to say, like, the we're wall to wall Holy Ghost.
Yeah,
amen.
We say that all the time.
We do say that all the time. Amen.
We need to be aware of that all the time.
So, what is the role of the Holy Spirit today, Marcia? What is the role in our life? What does he do for us?
He guides us, he directs us.
Amen.
He executes the power of God in us. When he says he's an executive, he's the executor.
He executes
the power. What God's will is in our lives.
God,
amen.
Yeah.
We always talk about him being our comforter, and we talk about him being our guide, but he also, as we speak the word, he executes that word through our lives.
Amen. I like John's, if you go on in John 16 there, in verse 13 and 14, he says this, "But when the Spirit of truth," that is the Holy Spirit, "comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak of his own, but will tell you what he has heard. He will tell you about the future. He will bring me glory by telling you whatever he receives from me." You know, Marcia, what I think it's interesting when you study the Godhead, when you study about the Father and Jesus and the Holy Spirit and how they interact and cooperate and work with each other. You know, Jesus, many times we read in the scripture, says, "The works that I do are not my works, they are my Father's
Amen.
Works. And the words that I speak are not my
That's
words,
right.
but they're my Father's words." The Jesus came to reveal the Father, didn't he?
Yeah.
I believe the Holy Spirit comes to reveal Jesus in each one
works,
of us.
The works what? That Jesus accomplished in our
and
lives.
And the works that he wants to continue
yes.
to accomplish,
yes.
you know,
it's like
us.
Healing. It's like
yes.
when you pray in faith, he's the one who executes the answer. So if when you believe for healing, he is the one who brings the healing into your life because Jesus accomplished it. He's saying, "This is yours."
Amen.
Just like salvation, when you come to Christ, who brings you to Christ?
Yes,
the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit is the one who does that.
Because the scripture says that no man can cometh unto the Father except he be wooed or drawn of the Spirit of God. So
right.
it has to be, someone can't just say, "Oh, I think I'm going to get saved today." If there's that not the unction of the Holy Spirit to do that, then really they're not being saved.
But you know, when you're talking about healing too, it's 2 Peter 2:24, we're always quoting that.
Yeah.
"He personally carried our sins in his body on the cross, so that we can be dead to sin and live for what is right." And at the very end it says, "By his wounds you are healed." Amen. You know, and in the mind of the Holy Spirit, you're already healed because he was there when Christ took the stripes on his back. The Holy Spirit was present when Jesus died for us and the things he accomplished for us. And so in the Holy Spirit's eyes, the second you believe, you receive if you stand in faith.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We need to understand that the things don't just happen at that moment. They've already been done. The atonement has already been finished.
Amen.
You know? So if salvation was in there, what else has to be done for us to be saved?
Nothing else.
Just to receive it. But in that same thing that had salvation in the atonement is also healing.
Amen.
And so what do we have to do to be healed? Receive that healing.
That's right.
That's what the Holy Spirit reminds us.
Amen.
Jesus has already paid for your sins. Jesus has already paid for your sicknesses. He's by his wounds, by his stripes, he did that. All you have to do is receive. So we say, Lord, I receive your healing in my body in the name of Jesus.
Amen. We have a confession this morning. It says, Jesus already purchased my healing. I want you to say that with me. Jesus already purchased my healing. And then according to 2 Peter 2:24, I was healed.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit is working effectively in my body to bring about the healing for me. That's our confession
today.
That's
our confession.
The Holy Spirit is executing his word in our lives.
Amen. Amen. You be blessed today. God bless you.
God bless
you. Have a wonderful day.